Hey there, viewers. Shaving, waxing, or plucking, no matter what the method is, many of us spend hours and money getting rid of our body hair. Today, it's all about clean and clear bodies. And some people are challenging the conventional thought. They're not ashamed of flaunting their hairy bodies. After all, what's bad about it? We're born with body hair, right? In fact, a few years ago, celebrities with ample body hair were in vogue. Some body hair seems to be making a comeback. So what is it that's bringing this hairy fashion back and has people refusing to shave their bodies? Well, it's more to do with the health benefits rather than showing rebellion or making a statement. In today's video, we'll be telling you about the benefits of being hairy and why you might want to rethink shaving. From protection against the sun, preventing chafing, saving you time and money, lessening skin rashes to better circulation and more. Watch until the end to find out all of them. Number 1. You'll save so much time and money. Two of the biggest drawbacks of shaving are how time-consuming and expensive it is. Shaving any part of your body usually takes at least 10 to 20 minutes if you want to do a thorough and safe job. And since you have to shave at least once a week to keep things trim, you're spending about 21 days per year shaving on the conservative side. Plus, a conservative razor pack is still about 12 bucks, which doesn't sound like much, but will definitely add up over the months. If shaving is worth time and money to you, go for it, but it's worth thinking about what you could do with the savings. How much money do you spend on shaving every month? Tell us the real number quickly in the comment section below. Number 2. Provides protection against the sun. Body hair dates back to our prehistoric ancestors. In fact, it was their only garment, keeping them warm and protecting them from environmental impacts such as sunlight. While few of us have dense enough hair to serve this purpose now, someone who's particularly hairy may have an extra degree of sun protection. Another historic function of body hair was to keep us warm. We do know that bald heads lose more heat, and when you're cold, your body hair stands on end to trap warm air closer to the surface of the skin. Number 3. Reduce breast cancer risk. A study concluded that women who shaved their armpits were 10 times more susceptible to breast cancer as compared to those who let their armpit hair grow. The researchers found that with shaved armpits, you'll have many invisible wounds and the pores in your armpits will swell. This will allow toxins and chemicals from various products such as deodorant, powder, and creams to easily enter the skin. When these toxins enter, they can be buried in the breast, resulting in the emergence of cancer. So, armpit hair protects your armpit against the toxic chemicals from cosmetic products. The lymph glands in your armpit may also facilitate toxin transport to other parts, leading to the growth of cancer in parts such as the lungs, heart, and brain, especially if the breast cancer has grown. Men are far more secure against this danger because they hardly shave their armpits. Number 4. Helps your skin heal. Hair anywhere on the body is important for maintaining skin health. Each hair follicle, which is the tiny structure that sprouts hairs, is not just producing a hair fiber, but also has masses of blood vessels, nerves, and fat around it. Hair follicles are also rich in stem cells, cells that never lose the capacity to renew themselves, which helps the skin heal. If you compare a wound on the outside of a person's arm where the hair follicles are larger and more numerous with a wound on the inside of the arm, the one on the outside would heal better. This is because of the increased stem cells and blood supply, among other factors. Similarly, a bald scalp is less able to cope with nicks, cuts, and bruising than a hairy one because of the lack of healthy follicles. As we age, follicles shrink, and people who lose hair will still have some stem cells. Their healing capacity may be reduced. Number 5. Protects your ears. Hairs in the outer portion of the ear canal prevent dust and other particles from entering your ear. However, excess hair in the ears may collect wax, which can block the ear canal and hamper hearing. So if you're prone to buildups of ear wax, you may want to consider trimming these hairs. But this may affect your hearing. This is because there's two types of tiny sensory hairs which help transmit sound signals to the brain. Those in the outer ear that boost soft sounds and reduce the loud sounds, while those in the inner ear that transmit the sound waves to the auditory nerve. In fact, very hairy ears could confer better hearing. However, there are no studies or tests yet to prove this theory. Number 6. Prevents chafing. Another function of hair is to provide a slippage zone, preventing chafing in areas where the skin surface rubs against one another. Ironically, these are often areas where people may be most keen on being hair-free, such as the armpits and bikini area. Even the finest hair coverage on the body provides this glide buffer zone. So, some people who shave under their armpits find it's uncomfortable to move their arms against the side of their body, like a carpet burn. Meanwhile, women who use hair removal creams around their bikini line may find that they're more prone to thrush, a common yeast infection that causes itching, irritation, and discharge. Some people may also have allergies to these products. An allergic reaction may then precipitate inflammation, which triggers an episode of thrush. Repeated hair removal in this area, whatever the method, can sometimes cause a minor infection called folliculitis. This disrupts the hair follicle, allowing bacteria to get into your hair's root. Because there's a high concentration of follicles in this area and increased sweat on which bacteria feeds, the chances of infection are higher. Number 7. Makes you less vulnerable to skin infections. No matter how long you've been shaving, it's impossible not to end up with a nick or two in the process, and those can be incredibly irritating or even get infected if not treated properly. But it turns out those little cuts can be dangerous depending on where they take place. Since hair acts as a sort of shield for your body parts, which are, you know, pretty exposed, the little cuts and tears from shaving leave you susceptible to infections. Another problem with shaving your body hair is that it can lead to a risk of causing micro breaks in the tissue and increasing your risk of infection. Number 8. You'll release more pheromones. A study claimed that one of body hair's major functions was to release pheromones. Though pheromones are still fairly mysterious, it seems as though they act as a way to attract potential mates. In fact, one of the pheromones called androstadienone has even been shown to increase a female's libido when exposed to it. So it turns out, all this time, you didn't need Tinder. You just needed more body hair. Number 9. Lesser skin rashes. Removing your body hair can be really tough on the skin, no matter what method you employ. Shaving, as we all know, is an easy way to end up with nicks and cuts immediately after, and razor bumps or rashes hours or even days later. Meanwhile, waxing, sugaring, and plucking can leave you vulnerable to painful ingrown hairs that develop when the new hairs try to push through the empty follicle. Number 10. You have lesser pain. We might have talked about a lot of cons of removing your body hair, but what about the fundamental pain of removing it in the first place? You're supposed to have hair, and it's not supposed to leave until it's ready to, so it makes sense that ripping it out early might be a little painful. Shaving might not be as painful as the other methods, but it's still pretty bad. Plucking or waxing, where the hair is yanked out of the root, is the most intensely painful. Laser hair removal, particularly in the pubic region, is also known to be particularly agonizing. Number 11. Better blood circulation. You may not like hair on your toes, but hairy feet is an indication that you have a healthy blood circulation. Hair follicles require a good amount of blood supply, or nutrients and oxygen, which makes the blood circulation smooth. It should be noted that the natural loss of hair on the feet or lower legs can be a symptom of peripheral artery disease. Maintaining a healthy blood circulation is very important for your body. To find out how you can improve your body's blood circulation, watch this video titled 20 Proven Tips for Improving Blood Circulation. Now, back to the advantage of body hair. Number 12. Hide annoying flaws. Have a little cellulite or random scars? If you stopped shaving, your leg or arm hair would hide those. Sure, it might seem awkward having hairy legs and arms at first, but you're happy and comfortable, so it doesn't really matter. It's much easier than cramming your legs into those hose all the time and wearing full sleeves during hot times. Number 13. You'll realize a healthy body image isn't about hair. People place too much weight on the body hair when it comes to body image. It's your body, and hair on it doesn't matter. You shouldn't have to spend hours and days of your life getting rid of the hair. You're beautiful just the way you are. And yes, that was a shameless Bruno Mars reference. Are you embarrassed of your body hair? How often do you shave your body hair? Tell us in the comment section below. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait! What kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.